Bottom of the screen we have the music score on top and tabs at the bottom, the six lines. I'll be using both of them to explain. So at the bottom, the six, each line would therefore represent one string on the guitar. So the top line represents the first string, the second line the second string, third line the third string, and so forth. So the numbers that appears on each line tells us which fret to be pressing on that particular string. If you have a look in the first measure, we have the number 2 on the third string, which would be that one. The next one is a 0 on the second line, second string. The small number indicates that you have to play it and you have to hammer down quickly from the open string to the first string. Also notice that this is 4-4 time, this piece is written in 4-4 time, and that on the first beat we have a rest. So you would count it 1, 2 and 3 and 4 and 1, 2 and 3 and 4 and 1, 2 and 3 and 4 and 1, 2 and 3 and 4 and. Right. On the last note in the first measure, for the third fret, that G note on the first string, I want you to press a bar at that point. So it becomes, which means that you're now ready for the second measure. And in the second measure, if you find those notes, you find that you're having to press the third fret on the second string, which I'm pressing under the bar, the third fret on the sixth string, which I'm pressing under the bar, and then the fifth fret. And that's, so we form that chord. Notice that fourth note, there's a curved line there that is called a tie, and it means that note is tied to the next one, so we don't play the next one, but we count it. 1 and 2 and 3. All right? And then the, so measure 2 goes 1 and 2 and 3, 4. So if I play measure 1 and 2 together, it becomes. Let's have a look at measure 3. Measure 3 there, we need to move to a full bar at the second fret. And if you find the notes, the 5th string note, the 1st string note, 4th, 3rd, second, we then end up with a chord of B minor. We have a tied note there as well, 1 and 2 and 3. All right, notice that after that we have, so there we are pressing the B on the fifth string. We are pressing the F already, so I want you to, after playing those two notes together, I want you with the second finger to hammer down onto the G and pull it off back to the F sharp. All right, so measure 3 sounds like this. Right, I'll be playing from measure 1 through to measure 3. Once more. At measure four, if you find those notes, most of them are the open strings. Once more. At measure five, it's a repeat of measure one, just that we have a couple of added notes. Once more. Measure six. Also, it's the same as what you played before. Measure seven. Back to the bar at fret 2, slightly different. So I'll now play it from measure 4 to measure 7. Again. In measure 8, what we've had before as well, so find those notes again. Measure 9. At that point, I again want you to go to a half bar at 5. Alright? Half bar at 5. So it's got the open string, 5th string, and the 5th fret on the 3rd string, which is under your bar. Alright? And once again, you need to hammer down from the 5th fret to the 7th. Alright? And then from 5 to 7, back to 5, hammer down and then pull off quickly. And then for that G note, you're going to find it at the 8th fret on the 2nd string. So the whole bar measure for measure 9 is this. Once again. Measure 10, we are still at the bar, half bar at 5. So repeat those notes. Now I have to add the D with your 2nd finger at the 7th fret and the B at the 7th fret of the 1st string. So the first half of measure 10 is. And those notes are tied over And then you play. So the whole of measure 10 sounds like this. Right, let's play from bar 8 to bar 10. Once again. Once more. At bar 11, we are still at the half bar, at measure 11, we're still at the half bar at 5, alright? So if you find those notes, once more. Bar 12. I want you from the 7 on the 2nd string, when you're playing the 7th fret to the 5th fret, with your 4th finger, I want you just to play the 7th note, 7th fret note, and then pull off to the 5. So measure 12 goes. Once more. Now notice that the last note is now held over, it's tied to the first beat of the first count in measure 13. It's also held over to the second count, second beat of measure 13, but from, and then after that, two and, you then have to play those notes. So I'm now speaking about measure 13, which has the fifth string E played at, the second string E played at the fifth fret, and the D at the third string played at 7, 5, 4, 5, 7, open first string, so it becomes this. Also notice that there's a curved line between the 4, 5 and 7 notes on the 3rd string. So what I want you to do there is play the 4th fret note on the 3rd string, hammer down 5, hammer down 7. Alright, so part of 13 becomes this. So, measure 14 then becomes, find the notes for measure 14, once again we have a tie. Right, let's play it from measure 11 to measure 14. Thank you. Incidentally, at measure 13, when you're playing the E on the second string, I want you to play that with your second finger. And then... measure 13 again. So I'll play it once again from 11. Changing to the second string. In measure 15, you need to find those notes. This is what it looks like. Alright, so the count's gonna be 1 and 2 and 3. Notice that you have to pull off from this F sharp on the first string to the open string. Measure 16, once again it's a half bar at 5, and you find all of those notes, and once again we're going to hammer down on the first string from the 5th fret to the 7th with the 3rd finger. Bar 16 again. Notice that in bar 17, the previous chord is held over for the whole bar. All right, and 1, 2, 3, 4. It's held over for the first beat of the 18th measure as well, and then once again the 18th measure is a return to the start. Okay. So if I do it, play it from 15 to 18, this is what it sounds like. Once again. Once again. As I said, at that point you are then back at the beginning and you play it right through until measure 16. At measure 16 for the second time, you would then come back, you would then skip to measure 19. You can see the bracket at 17, bracket 1. So when you get back there for the second time, you don't play bracket 1, you then move to bracket 2. But we're at measure 19. So notice, as I mentioned before, that after the repeat of the first section, when you reach bracket 1, you don't play bracket 1 again, you then skip to bracket 2, which you will find at measure 19. So let's have a look at measure 19. It ends with that same D chord. Mm-hmm. Right. Then for the next beat, I want you to press a half bar at fret 10, because there you will get your 10th fret note on the first string and the 10th fret note on the second string. You're going to play those together and you hammer on to the 12th fret on the second string with your third finger. Got that? The next part is you go back to the 10th fret on the 2nd string and the 12th fret on the 3rd string, so it becomes... The last part of measure 19, we're once again playing the 1st and 2nd string at the 10th fret, we're playing the 12th fret again at the 3rd string and the open 1st string. Right, so that last part of measure 19. So if I play measure 19, it becomes this. Once again. Measure 20, and now I want you to press a half bar at fret 3, because that is where you will find that third fret note. Right under the bar, you are also pressing the third fret on the first string as well as the third fret on the second string, and now you're going to hammer your third finger down onto the fifth fret of the second string. So, the first part of measure 20, again the first part of 20, and then second finger plays that A sharp on the 4th fret. Sorry, your second finger is going to hammer down onto the 4th fret. So, third finger finds the fifth fret and you slide the third finger up to play 7 and 7. Alright, so measure 20 becomes, measure 20 again, let me play 19 and 20 together for you. Alright, then 21, that now starts in a new section. Find the note, first finger on the 6th string for the 3rd fret. Second finger plays on the first string to get the G. Slide your second finger up to the fifth fret. Fourth finger at the seventh. And then you have the chord full bar at 7. Find those notes. So measure 21. Once again, right, let me play 19 to 21 for you, very slowly. Once more. Measure 22. Right. The last chord you played at measure 21 was that. Okay? B minor 7th. Now, you will notice that that chord for the last half beat of measure 21 is tied over into the first beat of 22, which means that you don't play that first half beat of measure 22, but the notes that follows is, that is the, I'm just noticing now there's a mistake in 22. The tab should have instead of fret 3 and fret 2, it should be fret 7 on string 3 and fret 7 on string 2. If you could just change that, that is measure 22 in the tabs. The 3 and the 2 should be 7 and 7 on strings 3 and 2. Alright? So from the for the last chord on in measure 21, it's tied over to beat 1 and then and 2. And 1 and 2. So from 21 it's and 1 and 2. And then we have another chord that you have to press. You put your 4th finger on the 10th fret, 1st string. 7, 7, 9. 9 7. All right, and this is the chord that you're going to strum, and that is also tied. So if I should take it again from measure 21, it's the last chord in 21, and 1 and 2 and again from the last chord in 21, and 1 and 2 and 3, it's tied to 3. And then the last beat in 22 is a bar at 6. All right, find those notes. 6, 6, 7, 6. That is a full bar at 6. All right, so let me show it to you now from the last chord in measure 21. And 1, and 2, and 3, 4. Once again, from 21, last chord, and 1, and 2, and 3, 4. Alright, you got that? Let's go to measure 23. And now as a full bar, you move back to fret 5. And if you find those notes, 5, 5, 5, 5. Alright? So let's go back to the last chord in 21, and 1, and 2, and 3, 4, 1. Okay, can we do it one more time? And 1, and 2, and 3, 4, 1. All right. At measure 23, we now have 1 and 2 and 3, alright? 1 and 2 and... So measure 23 sounds like this. 1 and 2 and 3. Again. Once again for 23, 1 and 2 and 3, alright, and 24, once again that last note from 23 is tied over to 24, so you just play the bass note, play it again from the last chord in 21 through to the end of 24. once again. And one and two and, sorry. And one and two and three and four and one and two and. Right, and that brings us to the end of that short section. Let me just play that that short section for you again, where it goes from. Okay, that is 21 through until 24. Let's do that again. Have a look at 25. You can see there's a change in rhythm. Now, if you should find the notes, firstly, I want you to put your first finger on the sixth string, fret 3, then fret 4, fret 4, and fret 3. This is the chord of G major 7th. Alright? Fingers 1, 2, 1, 3, 4, and 2. Alright? And this is the rhythm and how it's played. 1. Sorry, 1 and once again, 1. Right, I'm now going to play it for you once again from measure 21 until 25. Measure 26, you will see that it's the same rhythm as in 25. Just all I have to do is to find the notes. Open fifth string, 5, 5, 3. Alright, so the same rhythm goes. Again. You will notice 27 is the same as 25, goes back to. 8 is the same as 26. Alright, also see that between the G major 7th chord you're pressing there and the A chord you're pressing here, just all you have to do is to hold your 3rd and your 4th finger down on the string, slide them across and you get your next chord. And slide the 2 fingers back and you get your next chord, G major 7th. So if I play from 25 to 28, it once again, then it's this. I'll do it again, 25 to 28. One trick when you are playing two or three notes simultaneously, strings simultaneously, is to hold your, to not keep your right hand fingers apart when you're playing, but to keep them together so that it acts as one finger. So for example, when I'm playing the G major 7th chord, my fingers are not apart, but they are together, been held together by the tips, so it then acts as one finger. Thank you. we're at measure 29. Once again, if you check, we are pressing the G major 7th chord. There's a slight change in the rhythm. So he goes. And then first, second and third strings played. Then I want you to press a full bar at 3. And it ends with that A minor. Right, so the whole measure goes. Once again. Notice that the last chord in 29 is tied over to the first beat of 30. So don't play the notes again, but you can play the bass note. And find those notes. So 30 will be. Once again. Then 31 is a return to 29. Do it again, 31. All right, so 29 to 31 is. Once again, 29 to 31. So from measure 32, you will notice on the first beat of 32, there's a tie as well, which means your last chord is tied over onto the first beat, and one, and then find the notes. So measure 32, one, and two. 32, right, at 33, find the notes there. The first finger, you're going to press the 10th fret on the 5th string. Second finger on the 1st string, 10th fret. 4th finger, 2nd string, 12th fret. And 3rd finger, 3rd fret, 11th fret. And that same rhythm. Again. Once again, and then 34, you then press a half bar at 8, find the notes, 4th finger on the 10th fret, from I will play from measure 33 and 34. Once again, 33 and 34. Keep the half bar at 5 to now play the first beat on 35. Find the notes. So you have to jump quickly to the notes at G major 7th again. So, the start of 35. Five again. And 36 we played before. All right, 35 and 36 once more. And 36. So remember that the two dots at the end of the bar line that occurs quite often in the piece means that the previous section has to be repeated. All right. So if I should play that whole sequence, it goes like this. Was up to the end of 36 with repeats. If you have a look at measure 37, it's similar, still using the G major 7th chord, but this time I'm going to flatten my first finger to also press the F sharp in the second fret of the first string, which becomes one. All right, find the notes. The same rhythm. All right, we're at measure 38 again, the A chord that we pressed earlier, but now there's a slight difference to it, and we're going to flatten the first finger to then also reach the G of the third fret of the third string, which so it becomes once again, '39 goes back to the same notes at 37. '40 is the same as '38. All right, let me play '38 to '40. '40 again. Right, notice the sign at the end of 40. It says DSL coda, and that means that you go back to the sign at the beginning and you play until you see the coda symbol. And I'll explain that to you when you get there. So if you wish to go back again to extend the piece, you then go back to measure 21, where you're doing this section. wish to end it, once you get back to measure 40, you then go straight to 41, 42, 43, which is what you know. And then, at that point, we then lead to the end, which is the last two or three measures. We get to the end of the piece with measure 44, and just find those notes. Second part of that measure, find the notes with fingers 2, 3 and 4. I'll play 44 again. And we spread the G major 7th chord. And that's the piece. Have fun with it. Thank you.